Fast solar wind, blowing with gusts as fast as 800 kilometers as 1.8 million mph, a stream of solar wind is buffeting Earth's magnetic field. High-latitude sky watchers should be alert for auroras on January 13. Aurora Cygnus and the ISS, on January 12, a robotic arm on the ISS reached out and snagged another spaceship or Beagle Sciences Corporation Cygnus cargo carrier. Cygnus reached the ISS on time despite a launch delay last Wednesday caused by stormy space weather. The docking on Sunday morning at 8:05 a.m. EST marked the first successful contracted cargo delivery by Orbital Sciences. Only 5 hours before docking, the two spacecraft flew over the Netherlands, where veteran satellite observer Marco Langbroek was waiting with his camera to take this picture. The Cygnus cargo ship was too faint to be seen by the naked eye for most of the pass, but around 5:57:05 UTC it briefly flared to Mag+2 and the close duo ISS Cygnus was suddenly and briefly well visible as a result, says Langbroek. This picture shows the moment when the Cygnus flared. Cygnus delivered almost 2,800 pounds of equipment and crew supplies to the space station. This includes dozens of new science experiments including 23 designed by students. One newly arrived investigation will study the behavior of ants in microgravity. Another will probe the decreased effectiveness of antibiotics during spaceflight, a possible problem for astronauts on long space journeys. Yet another will explore how different materials burn in microgravity to improve fire safety in future spacecraft. More information is available from NASA. The January 13, 2014 M6.4 earthquake north of Puerto Rico occurred as a result of oblique thrust faulting. Preliminary faulting mechanisms for the event indicate it ruptured either a structure dipping shallowly to the south and striking approximately east-west, or a near-vertical structure striking northwest-southeast. At the location of this earthquake, the North America plate moves west-southwest with respect to the Caribbean plate at a velocity of approximately 20 mm/s, and subducts beneath the Caribbean plate at the Puerto Rico Trench. The location, depth and mechanism of the earthquake are consistent with the event occurring on this subduction zone interface. While the Puerto Rico Trench is known to be a significant seismic hazard, and is capable of hosting M8+ earthquakes, moderate to large events on the subduction zone are rare. Over the past century, three such events have occurred nearby to the January 13, 2014 earthquake, a M6.6 event in 1915, just to the east of the 2014 event, a M7.0 earthquake 70 km to the west in 1917, and a M7.6 earthquake in 1943 just northwest of the 2014 earthquake. Two earthquakes occurred in the Mona Passage approximately 100 km to the southwest of the 2014 earthquake in 1916 M7.0 and 1918 M7.3. While the 1946 M7.9 to 8.0 Hispaniola earthquake struck 230 km to the west, also on the North America slab interface. The July 1943 North Mona Passage earthquake did not cause significant damage in Puerto Rico, though it did spawn a small tsunami, and was the first in a series of large events in the broader northern Caribbean region between central Hispaniola and Puerto Rico over the following decade, including the larger 1946 earthquake. The 1946 event is known to have caused significant damage in both Hispaniola and Puerto Rico, including destruction from a subsequent tsunami. Seismotectonics of the Caribbean region and vicinity. Extensive diversity and complexity of tectonic regimes characterizes the perimeter of the Caribbean plate, involving no fewer than four major plates: North America, South America, NSCA, and COCOAs. Inclined zones of deep earthquakes were Wadady-Benioff zones, ocean trenches, and arcs of volcanoes clearly indicate subduction of oceanic lithosphere along the Central American and Atlantic Ocean margins of the Caribbean plate, while crustal seismicity in Guatemala, northern Venezuela, and the Cayman Ridge and Cayman Trench indicate transform fault and pull-apart basin tectonics. Along the northern margin of the Caribbean plate, The North America plate moves westwards with respect to the Caribbean plate at a velocity of approximately 20 millimeters. Year's motion is accommodated along several major transform faults that extend eastward from Isla de Roten to Haiti, including the Swan Island Fault and the Orient Fault. These faults represent the southern and northern boundaries of the Cayman Trench. Further east, from the Dominican Republic to the island of Barbuda, relative motion between the North America plate and the Caribbean plate becomes increasingly complex, and is partially accommodated by nearly r-parallel subduction of the North America plate beneath the Caribbean plate. This results in the formation of the deep Puerto Rico Trench and a zone of intermediate focus earthquake 70-300 km depth within the subducted slab. Although the Puerto Rico subduction zone is thought to be capable of generating a megathrust earthquake, there have been no such events in the past century. The last probable interplate thrust fault event here occurred on May 2, 1787 and was widely felt throughout the island with documented destruction across the entire northern coast, including Arecibo and San Juan. Since 1900, the two largest earthquakes to occur in this region were the August 4, 1946 M8.0 Samana earthquake in northeastern Hispaniola and the July 29, 1943 M7.6 Mona Passage earthquake, both of which were shallow thrust fault earthquakes. A significant portion of the motion between the North America plate and the Caribbean plate in this region is accommodated by a series of left lateral strike slip faults that bisect the island of Hispaniola, notably the Septentrional Fault in the north and the Anguilla Plantain Garden Fault in the south. Activity adjacent to the Anguilla Plantain Garden Fault system is best documented by the devastating January 12, 2010 M7.0 Haiti strike slip earthquake, its associated aftershocks and a comparable earthquake in 1770. Moving east and south, the plate boundary curves around Puerto Rico and the northern Lesser Antilles, where the plate motion vector of the Caribbean plate relative to the North and South America plates is less oblique, resulting in active island arc tectonics. Here, the North and South America plates subduct towards the west beneath the Caribbean plate along the Lesser Antilles Trench at rates of approximately 20 millimeters years. As a result of this subduction, there exists both intermediate focus earthquakes within the subducted plates and a chain of active volcanoes along the island arc. Although the Lesser Antilles is considered one of the most seismically active regions in the Caribbean, few of these events have been greater than M7.0 over the past century. The island of Guadeloupe was the site of one of the largest megathrust earthquakes to occur in this region on February 8, 1843, with a suggested magnitude greater than 8.0. The largest recent intermediate depth earthquake to occur along the Lesser Antilles arc was the November 29, 2007 M7.4 Martinique earthquake northwest of Fort de France. The southern Caribbean plate boundary with the South America plate strikes east-west across Trinidad and western Venezuela at a relative rate of approximately 20 millimeters years. This boundary is characterized by major transform faults, including the Central Range Fault and the Bakken San Sebastian El Pilar faults, and shallow seismicity. Since 1900, the largest earthquakes to occur in this region were the October 29, 1900 M7.7 Caracas earthquake, and the July 29, 1967 M6.5 earthquake near the same region. Further to the west, a broad zone of compressive deformation trends southwestward across western Venezuela and central Colombia. The plate boundary is not well defined across northwestern South America, but deformation transitions from being dominated by Caribbean South America convergence in the east to NSCA South America convergence in the west. The transition zone between subduction on the eastern and western margins of the Caribbean plate is characterized by diffuse seismicity involving low dash to intermediate magnitude and less than 6.0 earthquakes of shallow to intermediate depth. The plate boundary offshore of Colombia is also characterized by convergence, where the NSCA plate subducts beneath South America towards the east at a rate of approximately 65 millimeters years. The January 31, 1906 M8.5 earthquake occurred on the shallowly dipping megathrust interface of this plate boundary segment. Along the western coast of Central America, the Cocos Plate subducts towards the east beneath the Caribbean Plate at the Middle America Trench. Convergence rates vary between 72 to 81 millimeters a year, decreasing towards the north. This subduction results in relatively high rates of seismicity in a chain of numerous active volcanoes. Intermediate focus earthquakes occur within the subducted Cocos Plate to depths of nearly 300 kilometers. Since 1900, there have been many moderately sized intermediate depth earthquakes in this region, including the September 7, 1915 M7.4 El Salvador and the October 5, 1950 M7.8 Costa Rica events. The boundary between the Cocos and Nazca plates is characterized by a series of north-south trending transform faults and east-west trending spreading centers. The largest and most seismically active of these transform boundaries is the Panama Fracture Zone. The Panama Fracture Zone terminates in the south at the Galapagos Rift Zone and in the north at the Middle America Trench, where it forms part of the Cocos and Nazca Caribbean Triple Junction. Earthquakes along the Panama Fracture Zone are generally shallow, low-to-intermediate in magnitude and less than 7.2, and are characteristically right lateral strike slip faulting earthquakes. Since 1900, the largest earthquake to occur along the Panama Fracture Zone was the July 26, 1962 M7.2 earthquake,